more to the story than it would seem.
See, for this young man,
it was more than the wealth. He had a want to be something much bigger than himself, and that want to succeed would soon turn into greed. That need was fueled by his hunger. That's why he's chasing ghosts. Yo, yo, the future's looking daunting. We've all been affected by the ghetto haunting. Hey, yo, 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 the future's looking daunting. We all live with the presidential haunting. With cash, rules, forego benevolence. These days it's all about.
Be hassled by the police, you know, done stuff like that in the past, always hassled. But it's also, you know, helped the community get to know us a bit better in terms of what we do with the kids, what the kids need.
I've been working for Youth Off the Streets for 12 years. I've worked in a number of different programs, from residential programs to drug and alcohol programs, and now doing outreach. There's a few different kinds of outreach. There's outreach where you go out and walk around the streets and, you know, find out what's going on in the streets. This type of outreach is where we run a barbecue and run sort of a sports evening where young people come, spend some time, play some sports, have some food, that sort of thing. And it provides an activity for the young people to do, but it's also a place where the young people can come and they can access youth workers and bring up their problems. And because it's a weekly type event, it means that we can do it over and over again, and the young people start to get to know everybody. So yeah, there's an outreach out in Ayres, there's an outreach in Macquarie Fields, here, and then there's outreach in Doonside, and then we're also doing outreach out in some of the country suburbs, country towns, doing it out of Griffith and in Walgett as well. The main age group is say 16 to 17 18, but there's a whole range because it's an open thing. There's, you know, we do it out on the in the streets and stuff. We get a lot of young little kids coming, we get older kids as well, up to, you know, 21. Youth Off the Streets is funded by a number of different sources. Often we get particular sponsors that sponsor certain programs, and then there's also some of the programs are funded by the government. That, yeah.
What made you decide to do this video clip?
If you listen to the song, like, it was important to me to have something with more meaning behind the clip, not just to do a clip for the sake of doing something to have to play, but to actually have something that related to the subject matter, which is talking about greed and talking about a cycle that a lot of people were born into of not having options, of trying to not just make ends meet, but trying to gain some of the material goals that I think society implies everybody should be able to reach and achieve, but they don't necessarily have the means to. And so it's talking about some of the things that people do that. And Youth Off the Streets is a charity that directly helps kids to show them that they have other options besides having to pursue some of the things I talk about in the song. So.
Cool.
Yeah, the Chasing Ghost film clip, that was a typical sort of outreach night with the young people coming out there, having a game of basketball, dancing to music, yeah, playing sport.
And why the outreach program? Like, they run food vans, they run a whole lot of drug and alcohol clinics. Why did you go to the outreach program?
Because it was just more hands-on. I wanted something that was more tangible. To me, where I'm from in California, I always saw the programs that were actually doing practical and tangible things in the community were the ones that had an impact on my friends, at least. And so I wanted to contribute to something that was going to have a more practical approach to creating solutions for kids.
Cool. Talking to the kids, do you have anything in common with any of them?
Yeah, definitely. I think not so much, I mean, probably not as much now because I think moving to Australia changed a lot of my perceptions on options and things that you can do. It expanded, I guess, my view on things. But I think a lot of people like have blinders on. You're born and you don't see a lot of different options or things that you can do for yourself. And I think I would definitely relate to that. And more so, I see a lot of my friends. Characteristics of my friends back home and a lot of the kids here, and so it's quite close to home. Surprisingly, I can go halfway around the world and still find the exact same social issues prevalent that were back home. So,
did they surprise you, or were the kids exactly like you thought they were going to be?
It surprised me. They're a bit more switched on. I think kids are still like a bit wiser than I even was. I think kids are growing up faster these days, and so I was a bit surprised by how switched on and savvy some of them were. But yeah.
Did any of them know who you were?
No, absolutely not.
Yeah, the kids have really liked the video, as you saw by the response here. It was just really something that made the young people feel that they do have a place, and in that, you know, they can go home and they see, you know, video hits, and they see themselves on video hits, and they see their hometown in video hits. So it sort of made them realize that they do have a place in society.
Now I think a lot of them have seen it on TV. They've seen the clip, and they're a bit more excited and telling their friends and stuff. So I think now I got my fan base in Macquarie Fields going on strong.
And if people want to donate, what do they do?
They should go to youthoffthestreets.com.au, and there's a website on there and details how to donate.
Wait.
I'll see you soon.
You will.
Yeah?
See you soon, Thursday. Yo, Nan!
Where's this
going?
Where's Nan?
Are you taking a photo?
No.